guest Roger Stevenson.
We're singing in the rain, just singing in the rain.
Hello, I'm just on our way to the Cheggers Road Show, or should be Rail Show, really. As usual, we've got lots of competitions and plenty of things for you to do.
And luckily, I'm getting off at the next station because I'm going to be back in the studio. And with me will be David Bellamy, and he might be up a gum tree. But making me laugh will be comedian Willie Rushton.
As usual, lots of pop music and plenty of cartoons in the show.
And there's also going to be a chance to play Lucky Numbers.
Yep, so why don't you join us this Saturday on BBC One at 9:30. Okay. We'll see you then, hopefully. And hopefully it's not raining.
Oh, the weather!
Well, back to this afternoon now on BBC One for Crackerjack.
Rolling is your host, Stu Francis.
Kids! Oh, I'm so excited I could run in Liverpool's changing room and shout Everton. I've just been signed up by one of the country's biggest clubs, Whittycombe Wanderers.
What do you mean, who?
It's one of the oldest clubs in the country. Even the goalkeeper's 93. Do you know why they call us the Wanderers? We spend half the time looking for the ball. But fear not, I'll have you know all the top clubs have been after me. Only the other day, Brian Clough offered me terms.
Yes, that's right, for Liverpool.
For Liverpool, Brian Clough. Oh, very funnily, I'll have you know I'm one of the best sweepers in the country.
Yeah, we've seen you with your brush.
Thank you very much, Sally Ann. If you know so much about football, who's the best striker in the country?
Sally Ann's brother.
Sally Ann's brother?
Yeah, he's a shop steward at British Leyland.
Shop steward. We're playing Manchester United on Saturday.
Oh, Stu, please, can I...
Oh, no, Stu, I want to see you score a boundary.
A boundary? Oh, here. Don't say I never give you anything.
Oh, Stu, thanks.
Well, are they tickets?
No, red card. Get off. Oh. Early back. Get ready for take a letter. Girls, what do they know about football? Ooh, I'm so excited. I could overtake Ovette. Because I'm very tricky, you know. Last week, I sent Kevin Keegan the wrong way. He asked me the way to Liverpool. I put him on a train to Leeds. Do you know, actually, I always wanted to be a referee, but my legs were never thin enough. Have you ever noticed on the telly, referees' legs are always thin, aren't they? I think it's with keep blowing the whistle, it saps all the strength. But, get this, last week, I was invited to go along and train with the England squad. Me. Yeah, and just after the kickoff, Ron Greenwood came up to me. He said, Stu, I want you to find yourself an open space. I spent the next 40 minutes on a car park. But here is one of Scotland's top teams. They're the top of their entertainment league. It's the Crankies!
Interview tomorrow, and he's got to get himself nice and clean and tidy, so I told him to go back home and get changed. I mean, he was filthy, isn't he? Scruffy little devil.
Ow!
Crackerjack!
What's that you got there, Jimmy?
Oh, these are things I need for tomorrow. I'm going for a job as a designer.
You've got to be brainy to be a designer.
I am brainy. The man said I had to design something original, so I've done these.
What are they?
The town name signs for people who can't read.
That's daft. Anybody can read.
I can't.
What's that one then?
This one's great, look. That's a man with his head down a rabbit hole.
What town's that supposed to be?
That's Edinburgh. Eh? You get it? Edinburgh. Oh. Wait, you see this one? Wait, you see this? It's great, look, look.
That's a sausage.
I know, that's Bangor.
Oh. Yeah, I get the idea now. Hey, but look. That's a picture of me and your headmaster.
You're right.
What town's that?
Birkenhead.
Call me so cheeky. What about this one? It's a picture of you.
That's Minehead, of course.
Minehead. You're daft, Jimmy.
Look at this one. Look, look.
What's that? It's a ship upside down.
I know.
What town's that?
That's Hull.
Hull. Oh. Jimmy, the man will laugh at you if you go for...
I
I know, stupid.
I know, but look at this one. This is really good.
Now, don't help me. Don't help me. I'll get it. It's two dogs.
Yeah.
Barking.
Hey?
Barking.
Do they look as if they're barking?
No, they don't, actually.
But any fool can see that that's... You know what that is.
Well, I can't. What is it?
It's Leeds.
Leeds?
Oh, look at this. Sur le continent.
What do you mean it's somewhere on the continent?
It is.
It's a picture of an iceberg, by the looks of things, with a slice of ham on the top.
Yeah.
Where's that?
Hamburg.
Oh, Jimmy!
That's Hubba Dubba Doobie.
It's what?
That's my new word. Hubba Dubba Doobie.
Hubba Dubba what?
Hubba Dubba Doobie.
You may be very clever, Jimmy, at making up stupid, silly words.
Yeah.
But what will you do tomorrow if the man asks you to make up a town name on the spur of the moment?
That's no problem.
What?
I'll just do this.
What?
Prestatin.
Oh,
you get it? Prestatin.
You'll get it.
Hubba Dubba Doobie.
Oi, you'll get Hubba Dubba Doobie. Do you know whose hat that is?
What?
That's the producer's best hat.
Oh, ma'am, I've done it again.
You have, haven't you? Let's get in.
The game that isn't just fun, it's also fast. So let's join the two girls and find out who our first two contestants are. And Sally-Ann, this is?
This is Chris Keegan from Lancing, and he likes swimming and disco dancing.
How are you, Chris? Nice to see you. One or two fans in the audience, disco dancing. Who's your favourite group?
Madness.
Baggy trousers, dirty shirt. Yeah, fabulous. And Lee, this is?
This is Tom Davis from Oxford, and he likes football and reading.
Tom. Well, Tom, you're going to be playing against Chris, so let's decide who goes first. Tell you what, give me a number. Heads or tails?
Heads.
Heads it is. Would you like to go first or second?
Second.
You'd like to go second, see how it's done. Yeah. All right, then. Chris, if you'll come this way, we'll play Take a Letter. Right, then. Chris, you know the rules, don't you?
Yeah.
You do indeed. So you also know you've only got 1 minute and 30 seconds, don't you? So, Chris, if you're ready, take a letter! Off you go, quick as you can. Who's got the letter B? What have we got? We've got a question for you. In the Bible story, who wore a coat of many colours?
Joseph,
right, off you go. Take a letter, quick as you can. Who's got the letter O? It's come back to me. You've got another question. What is Paddington Bear's favourite food? No, it's marmalade sandwiches. Off you go. Take a letter. No point that time. You're doing well. You've got a point up to now. We've got the letter B. That means we've got a stunt for you.
Put the kilt on.
We'd like you to put the kilt on. As quick as you can, just put the kilt on. And that suits you. You'll get some stick tomorrow, the letter P. We've got another stunt for you, Chris. What have we got? Oh, we've got a ball of chocolate. Take the cork out with your mouth. Out the chocolate. Go on. Can you get it? I'll help you.
Yeah!
Right, take it as fast as you can. Hurry up, you're doing all right. We've got 3 points up to now. The letter I. We've got another stunt for you. What have we got?
Get the ball out of the hole.
Have you got it?
Go on, Stu.
Oh,
you can do it.
Oh, stop it.
Yeah.
There you go. Take a letter. You're doing smashing. Keep going, Chris. We've got the letter W. We've got a question. What sport is Robert Cousins famous for? Robin Cousins. Skating. Right, off you go. Take a letter. You've got 5 points up to now. We've got the letter J. We've got a stump for you.
Catch the egg on the plate.
Catch it. Oh, you've done it right. Scrambled eggs for one. And time's caught us up, Chris, but you did fantastic. In fact, you managed to score 6 points! Right then. Tom, you got 1 minute and 30 seconds, and you've also got to try and get more than 6 points. So if you're ready, Tom, I know they are, take a letter! What have we got? The letter L. We've got a stump for you. Put the bloomers on. Your friends are really going to love this. Go on, off you go, quick, have you got a win? You've done it, Tom, off you go, take the letter. There we go, we've got the letter T, we've got a question for you. Everton, Aston Villa, Forest, they're all names of what? Football club, right, off you go, take the letter. There we go, we've got the letter D, that means we've got a stump for you. out the porridge. Mark out the porridge. Can you do it? Go on, help him, Sally Ann. Go on, Sally Ann. Have you done it? Yeah, right. Take the letter. Off you go. You've got 3 points up to now. Hang on, we've got the letter Y. We've got a question for you. Where do kangaroos carry the young? Kangaroos. In a pouch, right. Off you go. Take a letter. You're doing smashing. Here we go this time, the letter K. We have got a stump for you. We've got a stump. Whistle like the cocoa and blow it. Can you do it with your mouth? Yeah, you've got it right. Here we go. 25 seconds left. What colour is a raven? A raven? No, off you go, don't worry about it. It's black, no point that time. It's black. What have we got? We've got the letter E, we've got a stump, we've got a stump. Catch the egg on the plate, quick, catch the egg, catch. Well done, Tom. Fabulous, well done. In fact, if you stand here, Tom, you also managed to score 6 points. Congratulations to both of you, but this means that only one of you can go through to our final, so I'm going to ask you a tiebreaker question, and the first person to answer the question correctly goes through to our celebrity take a letter. And the question is, nice and quiet, the question is, give me the name of one major railway station in London.
Charing Cross.
Charing Cross, it is. Yeah. Put me to the first there. What? Did you check then? No, she didn't. There you go, Chris. You've been a fabulous sport, and don't go away without your Crackerjack pen! Yay! Congratulations, Tom, and we'll see you later on in our celebrity game of Take a Letter.
Yes, once again, it's good news time, so let's start off with some good news.
I went fly fishing yesterday.
And the bad news?
I caught a £3 blue bottle.
Hey, Lee. I went for a walk last night, dressed in all white, so the drivers could see me.
What happened?
Got knocked down by a snowplow.
Here's some good news.
Last night, I dreamt I was eating mint imperials.
And the bad news?
When I woke up, I had no pyjama buttons left.
Hey, Stu, I got all my notes right at the Scouts last night.
That's good news, Jimmy.
No, it's no. Does anybody know how to untie our Scoutmaster?
This is Michael Richards, and he's got some bad news.
My sister fell out of her bedroom window yesterday, and the good news, we live in a bungalow.
And this is Rosa Parkin from Oxford, and she's got some good news.
The farmer says it's raining cats and dogs, which is good for the crops.
The bad news?
He just stepped in a poodle.
My brother's just joined the army. He's so young, they put him in the infantry.
Oh! Jimmy, that's terrible. Keep those jokes to yourself. But don't forget, if you've any jokes for us, then send them to us here at the BBC. And if we use your joke, you could win yourself a Crackerjack pen. So here's the address to send your jokes to. It's Crackerjack Jokes, BBC Television Centre, London W12 8QT.
Did you know Jimmy Cranky had a gang? Well, he has. In fact, they're all here now with a song all about it.
All around the country you can hear a happy noise. Here all join in, little Timmy, all the girls and boys.
Fun for all and all for fun, fun and games for everyone.
Come and have fun with us, join us today. Come on, join Jimmy's gang, Jimmy's gang, Jimmy's gang. All join Jimmy's gang, come with us today.
Jimmy's gang, Jimmy's gang, we Jimmy's gang heroes.
Jackie rules. Okay.
Second game of Take a Letter, and our next two contestants are Lee, first of all.
This is Rachel Lake from Lancing, and she likes swimming and reading.
Hello, Rachel. Welcome, Rachel. Nice to see you. You all excited? Yeah. Ooh, I could pop a balloon. Lovely. And Sally Ann, this is?
This is Elizabeth Davey from Oxford, and she likes reading and writing.
Hello, Elizabeth. Nice to see you. You like reading and writing, yeah? Perhaps you could teach Jimmy afterwards, because he can't read or write. Right, then, we've got to decide who goes first, so once again, we'll spin the coin. Elizabeth, heads or tails? It's heads. Would you like to go first or second? You'd like to go second. See how Rachel does. All right, then. Rachel, it's your turn. Elizabeth, we'll see you in 1 minute and 30 seconds. Come on, Rachel. Right, then, dear. If you'd like to stand there next to me, you know the rules of the game, don't you? You do indeed, and you're raring to go. So, Rachel, if you're ready, you've 1 minute and 30 seconds to take a letter! We've got the letter Y, we've got the letter Y. We've got a stunt for you, I've got a stunt for you. What have we got this time?
Beat the drum,
get the cut off. Come on, that's it. Yes, one more. Come on, that's it. We've got a question for you. Could you complete the name of the following story? Beauty and the Beast, right? Off you go. 2 points. We've got the letter S. We've got a stunt for you.
Put on the headdress.
We want to put the headdress on quick, fast as you can. Can we see where you're going? We've got it. Yes, that's another point. Right, off you go. Rachel, go on, faster. Come on, Rachel. Come on, Rachel. You've got 4 or 5 seconds left. The letter D. We've got a question for you. Where do the Wombles live? The Wombles on Wimbledon Common. Right, off you go. Take a letter. We've got the letter O. We've got another question for you. Complete the following pair. Batman and Robin. Right, off you go. Take a letter. She's doing smashing with that fair vote. J, we have got a stunt for you. We've got a stunt.
We've got to sing a pop song.
Sing a pop song. Any pop song you like, quick.
Yes!
One of those lonely nights, right? One of those lonely nights. Back to me, come on, back to bed. We've got the letter K. I've got a question for you. Complete the following proverb. Every cloud has a...
Seven lines.
You did. You just about got it out. I'll give you that, because you did get it out. So let's give a nice big round of applause. You got 7 points. Right then, Elizabeth. You've got to try and better 7 points. You ready? Right then, Elizabeth. Take a letter. Off you go. Right, we've got the letter W. I've got a question. Who is the lead singer of the Rolling Stones? Rolling Stones. No, it's Mick Jagger. No, quick, off you go. Still plenty of time left. We've got the letter B. That means we have got a stump. We have got a stump.
Put the symbols in your hand and catch 3 tennis balls.
3 tennis balls in the symbols. Quick as you can. That's
ready?
It. Go on. No.
Here.
That's. Turn around. Go on, go bounce them up. Again, Sally Ann. We want 3. That's 1. That's 2. 1 more. That's 3. Right, you've done it. Oh. Quick as you can, take the letter. You've got a point up here. Got the letter L. It's a question. If you went to Cross, which animals would you find at Cross? Cross Shore. Dogs, right, off we go. Take a letter, quick as you can. You've got 36 seconds left. The letter N. We have got a stunt for you. We've got a stunt.
Put the cloak
and the crown on, quick, fast as you can.
That's it.
Come on, I'll put that under your chin.
There
you go.
That's it.
Right, you've done it. Off you go. Take a letter. Right, we've got a question for you. 4 goes into 12. How many times? 4 into 12. 3, right, off the ball. Take a letter, quick, fast as you can. Don't worry about the cloak, I'll move that. Out of the way, we've still got plenty of time left. The letter I. That means we've got a stunt for you.
Yo-yo, 3 times.
We almost had a stunt for you. You did very well, Elizabeth. You managed to score 4 points. That is fabulous. Well, congratulations, Rachel, you got 7. Elizabeth, you got 4 points. There's your Crackerjack pen! Thank you for coming along, you were lovely. And Rachel, congratulations. We'll see you later on in our celebrity game of Take a Letter.
Hey, Jimmy, what are you playing at?
I'm practicing to be a puppet.
A what?
A puppet. Puppets make a lot of money. Look at the Wombles and Paddington Bear and Pinocchio. They all made money.
Yeah, Pinocchio's made of wood. Mind you, you've got enough sawdust in your head, you've got a good start.
Well, I'm not the only one around here who's silly, so there.
No?
No. Haven't you heard about the idiot who keeps saying no?
No.
Oh, so you're him.
Suppose you think that's very funny.
Yeah, it's funny, eh? But it's not as funny as tonight's special guest star.
Well, go on then, introduce him.
It's Popeye and his disco fiends.
It's nothing of the sort, Jimmy.
Oh, I've got it wrong again.
It's Pepe with his disco friends.
Oh, great.
Popeye.
Into the breakfast show. Oh, 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 oh.
Hands up, baby, hands up. Give me your heart, give me, give me, hands up.
game of Take a Letter, where each week our two competitors get a chance to compete in Take a Letter with two well-known personalities. And our personalities this week, girls, are...
From the world of comedy,
John Inman
and Wendy Richards.
John, nice of you to come along. I know you're very busy at the moment.
I am, mate.
That's that man from the telly, isn't it?
That's me, sorry, that's me.
What is it you say again?
I'm free.
I'm free.
He's free. I'm 10.
Jimmy. As I was saying, John, I believe you're very busy at the moment. Thanks for coming along. You're getting ready for pantomime?
Yes.
At the Mother Victoria
Goose,
Palace.
Victoria Palace.
Well, I wish you all the success with it. Have a good Christmas.
Thank you very
much. But right now, we're going to play Take a Letter. And I think this week, it's only nice if we have young ladies before young gentlemen. So, Wendy and Tom, if you'd like to hang on for approximately 1 minute and 30 seconds, John and Rachel, we'll play Take a Letter.
You all right, Rachel?
You know the rules. I know John's been watching anxiously. It's exactly as you played it before, only we do it alternately this time. All right. Rachel, John, you've got 1 minute and 30 seconds. If you're ready, dear, take a letter. Off you go. We've got the letter E. We've got a question for you. In the Bible story, who was found in a basket among the rushes? Moses, John, off you go. Take a letter. Where is John this time? Listen, you come back to me, Rachel. John, what have we got? We've got the letter V. It's not your day. We've got a stump for you, John.
Oh, no.
Toss the pancake. Three times. That's one. Two. Come into dinner. Straight back to me, Rachel. We've got the letter S. We've got a question for you. Black Beauty is the story about what kind of animal? A horse, right, John? Off you go. Take a letter. That's it, Rachel. You stay there. John, what have we got? It's letter J. We've got a stump for you.
Another one.
We have.
Find the kind of siren boxes.
In the boxes. In there, keep going, John. It's in there somewhere. Enter. Oh, it's just like Christmas. It's in there somewhere, John.
Do it.
Oh. That's it, we'll be there, John. Off you go, Rachel. Grace Brothers all over again. We've got the letter P, Rachel. We've got a stump for you.
Get the balloons in the bag.
Quick, fast as you can. Wait, I'll tell you what, I'll pop them first. You're going better, that's it. Keep going. We've got 8 seconds left. Right, John, off you go. We've got a question for you, John. How many eggs in half a dozen?
Six.
I think that's right. Off you go, Rachel. Take a letter. And time's caught us up. Rachel, come stand next to me and John. That's it, because you did very well indeed. Together you got 6 points. Right then, Wendy, Tom, you've got to try and beat 6 points. In 1 minute and 30 seconds. So if you're ready, Tom, take a letter. Off you go. What have we got, Tom? Straight away, the letter R. We've got a stunt for you. We've got a stunt for Tom. Jump through the hoop. Fast as you can. Take a letter. Quick as you can. Right, Wendy, what have we got? W, we've got a question. In which country is the city of Amsterdam? Holland, right, off you go. Take a letter, Tom. You're doing fine, Tom. We've got the letter B. That means we've got a question. Which insect makes honey? A bee, right, Wendy, off you go. Back to me, Tom. Wendy, Wendy, the letter N. We have got a stump for you, Wendy. We've got a stump. There's a football rattle in the box. It's in there somewhere, Wendy. That's it. It's in there. Give it a good rattle, Wendy. Right, Tom, off you go. Keep going. We're doing well. What have we got this time? It's the letter D. We've got a question. Who might you expect to hear say abracadabra?
A magician.
A magician, right. Off you go, Wendy. We've got the letter L. We've got a stump for you, Wendy. We've got a stump. Can you skip 5 times? No, it's stuck up there. Let go. Naughty, mate. Right, 5 times, Wendy. Keep going at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Go on, Tom. Keep going as quick as you can. We're doing all right, Tom. We've got the letter Y. What is Kevin Keegan famous for? Let's go. Football, right? Yeah. So, Wendy. Well done. Well done, Tom. You managed to score 7 points. That was fabulous. Rachel, if you come up.
Over here, darling, next to me. Well, you did very well indeed. Rachel, you managed to get 6 points, but Tom managed to get 7. You've been a fabulous sport. Here's your Crackerjack pen! And as an extra little prize, we've got you to take away one of Jimmy's Fan Dabby Dozy T-shirts. That'll look lovely on you. Thanks, you've been a lovely sport. Tom, congratulations. Have you decided which of our major prizes you'd like?
Camera.
You'd like the camera. John, if you'd like to present that to Tom.
I will, with pleasure. Do you want it round your neck, Tom? There we are.
That's fabulous. He's got his camera. Rachel's got a T-shirt and a pen. Let's give him both a nice big round of applause. Off you go. Well, welcome to the Bedlam once again. Thank you very much indeed. Boys and girls, mums and dads, Wendy Richards and John Inman.
Oh dear, just as I thought, just my luck. Breakdown here miles from anywhere. Well, what does this signpost say? Oh, I just as I thought, miles from anywhere. Oh dear, oh dear.
Right, that's it, that's fair enough. How about enough?
Brum, pop,
shut up, Jimmy.
Pop, pop.
Shut up.
Pop.
Jimmy. Pop. Right, that's it. Get off. I've had enough. I'm sick. Come here. It's all your fault.
It isn't.
It is. I said, fill it up. We've run out of petrol. I said, fill it up.
I did fill it up.
What with?
Sweeties.
Sweeties. Engines do not run on sweeties.
Engines do not run on sweeties.
What do they run on?
Roads.
No, they don't. Well, they do run on roads, but you know exactly what.
When you drive, they run on the pavement.
Excuse me.
Oh, no, dear me.
I wonder if you could help me.
No.
It's my car. It's broke down.
No, I can't. No.
I'll pay you £10.
£10. Yes, I'll do it.
I'll
get
right. I'll have a look at the engine.
Nice people,
isn't it? I'll do it. Now, what's this?
What's this?
I'll give it a pull.
Aye.
It's stuck.
Oh, I'll come and give you a wee hand.
Just give it a pull. One, two, three.
Help!
What's that?
I'll have a wee look. Oh, dear. The wee chap's got stuck in the mud guard. I'll pull him out.
Help!
Oh,
I'm stuck.
Let me have another look. Oh, the big fella's got stuck in the engine. I'll pull him out.
That's better.
Yeah, that was terrible. What a mess you're in.
Good grief.
Wasn't that funny?
That was very funny.
Yeah, it was very, very funny.
Well, I think we should try a jump start.
Try a jump start? Do you think a jump start would help?
Yeah,
okay.
I think so. Now then.
Right!
What did you do that for?
I was making it jump and start.
That was stupid.
It was your idea.
Look, stand over there and shut up.
Please, hurry up and mend the car, will you? I'm in a hurry.
I will. Just thinking. It's very nice. Aye. She's a very nice car. Aye.
Sounds just like my mum.
She's seen better years.
Sounds just like my mum.
And she's got a terrible leak in the rear gasket.
Sound exactly like my...
Jimmy!
I was going to say my motorbike.
Look, just stand there and behave yourself. Excuse me, sir.
Aye.
Have you had the car long?
Oh, I'm 10 years now, aye.
We Japanese know a fling or two about British cars. British cars, no flipping good.
Jimmy!
Can't I help?
No. Well, come here, stand there.
Yes.
Now then. Jumps there. Hold that wire.
And you hold that wire as well.
Right. Now then.
Right. See if you can start it.
If we can connect the circuit, yes. We'll be laughing.
Right.
Jimmy! Oh,
dear. How are you down? Isn't it? What do you want to think we can do? Take the wire off.
Quick, get hold of that. Put him up there.
Oh. Well, that's a good idea. Oh, dear. Now then, please, hurry up and mend my car.
Very good, sir. And you stay in that car.
Oh, good. I'm getting staying in the car. Hubba dubba dooby.
Hurry up and mend the engine, will you?
Right, sir. Ah, look at that.
What's that? Just fix it. Oh, look, I think that might be the trouble in there.
That's it. I've had enough. Get out. Get out of that car.
I can't.
Dad,
why not?
The gear stick stuck up my shorts.
Get out. Sick and tired of you. You're messing about. Man's car.
Me, I'm going to be terribly late, you know. Really, really late.
Hey, mister, late for what?
The circus, of course.
The circus?
Where else do you think I'd use a car like this? I'm a clown, look.
Oh, he must have got his clothes for madness.
Baggy trousers.
Baggy trousers.
Baggy trousers.
Just my luck to meet a couple of idiots like you. If only I'd met somebody that could mend my car.
Oh, excuse me.
Hello.
Perhaps we could help.
Yes,
help?
We'll soon mend your engine.
I'm sure girls mend a car. What would girls know about cars? Girls know nothing about nothing.
Oh, it started! Oh. Right, Alice, you can't walk to the circus. Come on.
Of course I could have done it.
We're going to the circus.
If only they had let me do it, it'd have been no problem. Because all I would have had to do was just turn this wee knob here and...
But we'll leave you now with our Crackerjack song.